Well, we have Wall Street Bets, everything that you need to know. Also, a huge trend line. I'm going back to the Great Depression. You guys need to take a look at this to see what kind of downside we possibly could have, and huge manipulation in Bitcoin. And hey, you know all these stimmies that are coming out? How are we going to pay for that? Oh, that's right, taxes. And for all of you Wall Street Bets kids, maybe you're not kids, maybe you're adults, maybe you're some old men, ladies in wheelchairs. You're like, yeah, I'm going to manipulate this market. You can't really talk about Bitcoin. Uh-uh. No. You got to have your own little separate thing for that. But you guys are turning to crypto miners. And I want to throw in my Canadian friends on this one. We have miners Riot. Mara up over 7,600%. And these are like buying stocks that are kind of Bitcoin, but without the risk. It's kind of like when Warren Buffett says, I will not buy gold. Well, okay, how about the miners? Since we're in a bull market, what about the miners? Can I have that? Is that cool? It's not so shiny, but it works. So Reddit, the message boards, no cryptocurrency rule. But let's take a look at how they're kind of sneaking around that. So here is a stock, Riot Blockchain Incorporated. It's not Bitcoin, not cryptocurrency. These are just stocks trading on the NASDAQ. And look at these double bagger gains. Actually, back in high school, I used to have to wear a double bagger over my face because the girls were like, but what if the first one breaks? I'm like, okay. And now my wife just puts the plastic ones on my face. I'm like, can't you still see me? So yeah, it's okay. It's your breath that I can't do. Looking at Riot Blockchain, and I have to say, this is not financial advice. See above my head, this is paper trading. Ah, so you lose no money. You just paper trade. See, right up there, it says paper trading way, way, way up there. Can never be financial advice. I'm an idiot. You will lose 100% of your money. And if you do it on margin, it's even more. And if you leverage, then you lose that. You don't want to do that. Look at these things. Take a look at Riot. Also, here we have the Go-Go Juice. It's okay. I'll take it. We're good on that. That's a gooder. There we go. Crossover right there. Padink. And then last but not least, for those of you that are like, what the heck is all this? These are called my crystal balls. I have a few of them in my bag. And then I use these said crystal balls to go, do I want to buy something or do I want to sell something? And then the people that buy and hold all, they say, you never want to sell. And the people that swing trade are like, wow, I'm glad I got out of that position. But on this one, you're going to be a little surprised. Riot Blockchain. So you guys are currently up at the top, if you're a narcissist, 771%. That's it. And if you were swing trading, you kind of pulled off a little bit, pulled out just a little bit, and then you went right back in. That one, I mean, look at these swings. Why? 190% just right there. Just me just whoop. Clicking and another entry right there. Buy. Maybe you want to wait a little bit. Even if you waited, this is on the daily. Also, I have a simp code down below because I had some of y'all were saying, hey man, my wife said if you can bring the course down just deflationary for one day to 249, my wife said I can buy it. So a 24-hour sale starting last night, going through today, 24 hours, link in the description. I think if you put in simp, it works. Or you just grab the link in the description. Rather than paying $2,000, $2 billion because of inflation, because you guys want inflation. I say deflation. It's taking it down a little bit. But look, see the little red indicator? And it came on. You're like, okay, it's green. What's this run just right there? What are we at? 18% just on that little baby run. And you're still buying and holding on paper trade. And for my Neo peeps that didn't like me when I called Neo going down to in the 30s, they're like, oh, well, you can't do that. You don't know anything, Mr. Bravo. You're just a cartoon. Real quick, and then I'll get off of it. I actually had my high school students. Let me close my position because it's interrupting me. Look at Neo on the daily. You got a little greeners, little green. Right. Can I get it? Can I touch the tip? There it is. There we go. I'm hitting it. You got your buy coming on. We're above the 200 on the daily. I just don't like that red candle right now, but other than that, looks okay. And hey, Neo kids, we may just go right back up into that channel. That'll be nice, right? Yay! On this channel, I just show you, everything goes in channels. That try to keep it simple. You want to know what's not simple? I told you that Bitcoin, you can't talk about that. You cannot. You are banned from talking about Bitcoin. Is this? Oh my gosh, the manipulation. Now, oh, let me get rid of myself. I saw this and I'm like, should I do a live stream? Yeah, you're like, oh, nothing's happening. When usually, do you see these red lines, all miners outflow, and then boom, Bitcoin gets slammed down. All miners see, boom, slam down, slam down, slam down, slam down. We're like, oh, hey, we can kind of see what's going on. Now, why, oh, why did it cut? Why did Bitcoin get slammed down when I go to my all miners outflow? Well, that's because now you guys are getting kind of smart. You're heading over to Gemini. What? Look at that. Boom, slam, boom, slam. Another one, Ethereum. And you guys are using wrong one. This is my main screen that, you know, I go through and I'm like, is it this one? Are you guys using this one? You know, what's going on? Bitfinex, look at that. Bam, slam it down, slam it down. We will have to wait. It could be now for those of you that are buy and holders of this little magical coin, this little poof, pixie dust, BTC, also known as the Bitcoin. You wouldn't even have spotted that, right? If you're trading on the high, Kanashi still say bull market, son, keep it going. But if you were to switch it to the 1 hour, you guys want to trade the Bitcoin? Or do you want to accumulate that said Bitcoin? And even on the 1 hour, we're starting to come out of it. And they just keep trying to push it down. Too bad there's a limited supply. And remember, kids, on stonks and bonds, it's unlimited. You know what? If you own a company like, said, let's take Apple. And you're like, oh, wow. Hold on, let me try this again. Said Apple. There we go. Ha! Look at these indicators just work for everything. Is this the, hold on, that's not the 200. Did we fall below, hey kids, did we fall below the 200 on Apple yet? Are we still above it? Whew. All right, we bounced right, actually that's the 200, the blue one. I got a little scared on that one. But these companies can just create a bond out of thin air and then they just, print, they get money. Wouldn't that be nice? But remember, everything is a derivative of the bond market. So make sure when you guys are in the markets, that you look right here. This is your government bond. You got to take a look at the bond. And when that yield goes up or goes down, that's what, you know, dollar goes up, market. Not always. It looks like we're actually kind of being okay with this yield right now. I'm like, is it the stimmies? You guys okay with 1.61? How is this? Is the tech stocks getting beat up a little bit today with a 1.? That's a move. And I'd say looking at stocks today, it's kind of wonky all over. Apple, we got Apple up, AMD up. You guys okay with the higher yields? Are you guys sure? What else do we got? We got Dash down. All right. Douchey Bank down. DraftKings really down. Ethereum beat down. But we saw this one. We knew it. They're trying to beat down the Ethereum. But at the end of the day, you're like, hey, what about Cardano? Because believe it or not, and there will come a time that you're going to gain an interest rate, right? For staking your coin. We'll just set it there. We'll just hodl for a little bit. Isn't that nice? Like, these are banks that are on the interwebs that will pay you to stake. What are we looking at? Look at Cardano, ADA, if you guys want to take a peek. Yield, set, that's pretty good. The yield on the staking pool, I mean, you're not getting the pool, the whole pool, that's 771%, 1,000%, 22% yearly on ADA. And one of the guys in my course actually has a staking pool. You guys can all come and swim. You get a percentage just by holding it, just keeping it there. Because there's a difference between proof of stake and proof of work. Do you want a stake or do you want the work? The corn is the work. The Cardano is the stake, but I think it's going to be really cool that in our lives, in your lives, that you're like, hey, I'm getting an interest rate, 8%, 7%, just by holding and to even think. I mean, and this guy that in my course created a staking pool was very, very bullish on Cardano, which he should have been, is up almost 500% this year. Congratulations. Took that said money and paid off his house. And then other companies like BlockFi is like, okay, well, if you put your coin on ours, we'll give you 8.6%. Thank goodness, right? Finally, finally, we're getting back to some normalcy in banking-ish, right? It can't really be a bank. It's banking-ish, but you could just put it on. Also, link in the description, BlockFi, they give you $250 if you put so much in there, and then they pay you interest just by holding it there. Although I do get kind of upset because I move it back and forth. I like swing it. I'm like, okay, Bitcoin got beat down. All right, we'll swing some over here. And then it goes up and then we swing it back. And I just, we go back and forth. And I'm like, great, I made all this money on my APY, right? They pay you interest. But I'm like, oh, if I just would have held it. And I do think that in this bull run, you could probably see Bitcoin up to 300,000. It's just me throwing stuff on the walls based on what I've seen, what I've been doing for many, many of moons. And then you're going to see a huge pullback and you're going to go, shoot, I wish I would have just moved it back over. But I will tell you, whenever you swing trade Bitcoin, you feel terrible when you do it because you're like, I'm only getting 9%. And it's mooning from whatever, 10 to 60, from 60 to 100, from 100 to 200. You're like, ah. So be careful, kids, on the swing trade on a bull market in crypto. And for those of you that just like traditional securities, well, I got one for you. The Dow Jones Industrial Average. You want to see something kind of cool? Here is it's right above me, 100-year trend line. This is back to the Great Depression. Remember that big dumpster dive? Well, every time it hits that, right? Dumpster dive. Those are big losses, kids. I'm just saying. And guess where we're at on that trend line? And guess why this person is short? Because we are at the top of that trend line. And I'm trying to zoom in for you, but now let me push the button. You see where we're at? Hold on. Let me push the button and ba-dink. Where are we at? We are so on the top. And actually, if I were to really zoom way in, actually, that's almost too much of a zoom. Can you guys see that? Let me, one more. Can you see this? We're actually above that trend line. Are you ready for a blow off top? Or are you ready for a super sell off? Well, I guess we will just all have to wait and see. And also for my Canadian peeps in the audience, and since we can't talk Bitcoin, you got Voyager coming in from Canada, Voyager Digital. Look at these double, triple, quadruple baggers. And if you were trading this on the daily, do you trade on the daily? What? Woo! That was your buy indicator. What was at the top? 288%? Where are you guys at right now since that indicator flashed? 240%. Oh my goodness. But we got some dumpage right there. And I have to be honest with you, the only dumpage that I would want on my face, Carl, would probably be a chocolate shake. That would be good. You don't want meat. Meat dropping on your face, that would hurt. But although I changed my mind, I'm more of a vanilla kind of a guy. So a vanilla shake dropped into my mouth, that would be good. And then coming in from good news, bad news, Bloomberg, Wells Fargo, JPMorgan sees customers. They're upset. They're unhappy. Well, go, okay, this is what you do, customers. You didn't get your stimmy check. Go to Wells Fargo. They have a Yelp and just, but does the Fed have a Yelp page? I would probably one star them. Although it is coming from the Treasury. It's either Janet or Jerome. This is just one star. And actually, when I do search for Federal Reserve, Yelp, bank. Okay, good. 4.5 stars. San Francisco, looks like you guys, it's like Janet and Jerome are like, hey, any friends, you hop over there. Please give us a review. We'll give you some currency. And this is exciting. Are you not excited? You're going to get stimmy checks. Oh, taxes. Shoot. Is that how the system works? In a debt-based system? Where do you come up with this? Oh, inflation? Oh, okay. Eats away your purchasing power. So even though they give everyone $1 million, do you really have $1 million? And I would say, yes, you do. Prices will not go up. Biden eyes first major tax hike since 1993 in his next economic plan. I can guarantee you, I know this is not a political channel, but I can guarantee you it will just be for the wealthiest of wealthy times wealthy. Taxes never affect you kids, right? No. You don't even have to worry about this $223,000 that you have to pay back in your taxes. It's okay. You'll be fine. And when the government says that this $2 trillion of stimmy is going to the people, and yet $1.5 trillion goes back to the government and businesses, and you're left with some pocket change and you can't figure it out, and now you're mad, well, you've come to the right place. Because on this channel, I will give you the truth until they remove me, which I'm pretty sure they will. But hey, it was a fun ride while it had, How do you finish a sentence with while it had? I don't know. It was fun while it lasted, right? So I give you everything that I can possibly think in my head. Okay, so we're going to swing trade the stocks. We're going to start businesses. It's deflation, so I give you coupon codes of simp. Don't forget about that, because when it's gone tomorrow, you're going to get mad at me and you're going to be like, please, my wife grounded me from the computer and I didn't have access. It'll sound like my high school kids. Can I do the homework now? I'm so sorry. It's been all year. Now my mom took away my cell phone and oh my gosh, I don't know what to do. And if you are just here for the entertainment purposes only and you've made it this far and I've given you some kind of value, can you just little push? I'll just go right onto that button, put it right in that button, and just take it right out, and I will see you tomorrow.